for you. Have a final say. You see the way. Can you have the final say? You move the bone. You break the bone. You believe.
Yes, we believe. We believe. Y'all just stay with me just for a minute. I'm waiting for some other people to come on the line. We're going to get ready to get started here. And I hope you get your paper and pen out, a pencil. Somebody say for what? That you be able to write all these scriptures down and also write down the name of everybody that's on the prayer request list. Because the prayer request list has changed. And I need y'all on here praying with us, praying for us, and praying for everybody that's on the prayer request list today. It's time for us to get wild, amen. Thank God for Sister Betty coming on. God bless you. Leave you soon. All right, let me go over this prayer request list right quick. And then we're going to get ready to pray and seek the face of God. The Bible says all things are possible to them that believe. And so he said it, we believe it. Somebody say he said it, I believe, and that settles it. It doesn't make any difference whether you believe it or not. It's yet settled. Because the Bible says that the word is already settled in heaven. My God, I've been telling y'all that the year of 2022 is the year of the manifestation of your expectation of all the things that you've been praying and seeking God about. This is your year. This is your hour. This is your time. Are you listening to me? And so once you get that in your spirit and stand on the word of God and believe what the word says, the word doesn't do any good if you don't believe what the word says. We just got through preaching and talking about the year 2022, the year of upgrade. Powerful message. Because when we were dealing with this message, bear along with me for a minute. We were dealing with this message and we brought the scripture text out of 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse number 20, where the Bible says that for all the promises of God in him are yea, and in him, amen, unto the glory of God by us. So now God said, whatever I promise you, Lord God, that make me want to shout right then. I thank God, Mother Keller put on the screen, Lord, I thank you. It is already done. As the type of, I love that. She put on, I believe what God say. That is powerful. Now, when you look at the number 2022, it has three vibrations of two. Multiplying its properties in this number, it only makes sense that 2022 means balance, means faith, means success, manifesting miracles, and new opportunities. If you're looking for a fresh start to your new year, this number may just do the trick. See, we was talking about how that the year of 2022, we started talking about this back in November, I think, the year of the upgrade. And in October, somewhere along there, I was telling people about 2022 going to be the manifestation of all of your expectation, all of your disappointments and stuff. You need to get yourself in a position where with God, that God would release these things into your care. Are you listening to me? And so we was talking about this, not realizing and not even understanding what the number 2022 was saying. There was a prophetic word that God was releasing to the body of Christ. I was talking to a gentleman on the other day. He told me, say, I'm taking this back to our church. Because I began to explain to him what 2022 means. And I write this down. Because we're talking about 2022, the year of the upgrade, the year of the manifestation of your expectation. Are you listening to me? And let me say this. I'm trying to see what I did with my list. My list of everybody that sold into the Kenyan Project. Amen. I do not want to forget. I want to go over all of these names that sold into the Kenyan Project. Are y'all with me? And let me tell you something. In this month alone, God has been pouring out, releasing. I'm talking about unbelievable financial breakthrough in my life. In this month alone, I need y'all to catch it, because the Bible said, believe the Lord your God, and so shall you be established. But then it said, but believe ye the prophets, and so shall you prosper. If you are sitting in anybody, and if you can't trust what they say and stand on what they say, you're probably in the wrong place. Come on. I was just talking about the year of the upgrade, the year of the manifestation of your expectation. I was talking to a sister the other day, and she got a $15,000. Listen to me. She got a $15,000 that she was not expecting. Lord Jesus. Oh, yeah, I don't think y'all getting it, because the word was already spoken. I spoke the word back in, I think, October, November, December, about this was going to be the year of the manifestation of all those things that you've been praying and seeking God about, and God doing just what he said. Now, because the Bible says, beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prosper. And this is what we was talking about Sunday. How that God said, when he said, beloved, thank God for Evangelist Daniel Hillary coming on. When the Lord said, beloved, I talk about this scripture quite a bit. I think there's only one other scripture that maybe two other scriptures that I talk about more than this. And one of those scriptures is, he that findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtained favor of the Lord. But my most favorite scripture in all of the word of God, where the Bible says, now unto him that's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we act or think, according to the power that worketh inside of us. So now the Bible says, beloved, above, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper. I'm speaking to you. I'm speaking to you right now. I'm speaking into your life right now, if you receive this word. If you stand on this word, if you apply this word, I'm speaking to you. It's up to you to receive it. Listen to what I'm saying. God is speaking to us at the body of Christ, but we have to take this word and hide this word in our heart and believe that it's already done by faith. Cast it, because the Bible says, beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper. Now, the Greek word here is holos. It means to help on the road. It means succeed in reaching. It means to succeed in business affairs. It means to have a prosperous journey. It means good. It means well done. It means progress. So God is telling us that he wants us to progress. God is telling us that he wants us to have help along the road. God is telling us, he's telling us that he wished that we would succeed in whatever we're going out. Are you listening to me? God is telling us that we should have success in business affairs. Thank God for Sister Jackson coming on. Catch this. He said that thou mayest prosper and be in health. Now this word health comes from the Greek word hugis. It means to have sound health. Listen to me. Be well in body. To be incorrupt, true in doctrine. See, it's not just talking about physical health, but it's also talking about the doctrine that you believe, that the word that you receive, the word that you teach, the word that you learn. It means to be incorrupt and to be true in doctrine. It also means to be in health, to be safe and sound. Now catch it, because this word also means to be whole, W-H-O-L-E. See, a lot of times we pray for people for God to heal them, but we don't seal that prayer with be thou made whole. There's a difference between being healed and being made whole. You could be healed and the symptoms may remain. But when you're made whole, that means that God not only heal your body, but the manifestation of it take place right then. Oh, God. So now, it goes a little bit further. Say, he wished that you prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prosper. Are you listening to me? And so now God is telling us our Sukkot, our soul, have to prosper. The spiritual man, the immortal soul, your mind, your will, your emotion, all of that have to prosper. In other words, God say, when your soul begin to prosper, your health and your wealth gonna break forth. My God. Now the Message Bible say out of 30 Epistle of John 3:2, the Message Bible say, we are the best of friends and I pray for good fortune in everything you do and for your good health, that your everyday affairs prosper as well as your soul. Lord Jesus, I just said something. This is what I'm speaking into your life right now. It's up to you to receive it. Because the Bible says, he that receiveth a prophet in the name of a prophet shall receive a prophet reward. Come on. So I'm praying right now for everyone that's on your watching me by live streaming. I'm praying for your good fortune and everything that you do. I'm praying for your good health. I'm praying that your everyday affairs prosper as well as your soul. My God, I just said enough for you to shout right there. Now, I'm going to give you the definition for 2022 one more time. Now, it's up to you to receive it. It's up to you to reject it. But I'm telling you, when you receive, the Bible says, receive a prophet in the name of a prophet, and you shall receive a prophet reward. I'm telling you that testimonies are already coming in. Since 2022 came in, testimonies are already coming in. Let me rehearse this in your spirit one more time, because the spiritual man, the inner man, need to get this. 2022, our church theme last year for 2021 was the best is yet to come. Our theme, thank God for Evangelist Hodges, our theme for 2022, you need to get connected to this. I'm telling you, money been flowing in my house this month alone. And I'm not the only one. When God give a prophetic word, it's up to you to receive that word. Amen. Thank God for Sister Joyce Lewis, Brother Davidson coming on. God bless you. Now, let's deal with 2022 one more time. Then we got to go to our prayer request list. We got to pray. But I'm so excited about what God is getting ready to do. The theme for 2021 is that the best is yet to come. The theme for 2022 at our church is that it's time for the year of the upgrade. 2022 is the year of the upgrade. Thank God for Sister Ruth Hills coming on. God bless you. Are you listening to me? So now, if this is the year of the upgrade, I had already spoken that this is the year of the manifestation of your expectation of the thing that you've been praying about, the thing that you've been seeking God about, and it seemed like it is an illusion. God sent me to tell you God sent me to tell you today, you need to tap into this. This is a prophetic word that comes straight from heaven. I did not even know what this word meant when I told the saints that this was going to be the year of the manifestation of your expectation. 2022 has three vibrations of two. Are you listening to me? Multiplying its properties in this number. It only makes sense that 2022 means balance. God said, I'm coming to bring some balance in your life this year. It means faith. God said, look, when you pray in the Holy Ghost and you will receive this word, your faith is going to explode. It means success. Whatever your endeavors are, whatever job you're seeking, whatever business you're trying to start, this is the year of manifestation. It means manifesting miracles. Are you listening to me? I need y'all to catch this. It means new opportunities. So if you're looking for a new fresh start, this is the year. This number may just do the trick for you. My God, my God. I'm excited. I'm excited. Let's pray first. Let's pray first. Oh, Jesus. I'm just excited about what God is doing. I'm telling you that God already started. I want to remind you that the music you're playing in the background, we do not own the rights to this music. Gracious Father, we thank you right now for every name on this prayer request list. And God, we come praying for Brother Clyde Smith, even now, God. God, as he goes into surgery, God, we decree and declare he shall come out victorious. Touch his body right now. God, heal right now. Deliver right now. And God, we're praying for Brother John Denton. Thank God for Sister Ann and Megan coming on. And God, we pray that you give Brother John a miracle that will blow the minds of the doctors, God, and family members. Blow his mind. Because we know that you're able to do exceeding abundant above all that we ask or think. So God, we curse every cancerous cell in his body. We curse it at the root, the core, and the cause of it. And by Jesus' stripes, we send the word to Brother John Denton's house and say, by Jesus' stripes, be thou healed. In Jesus' name. Father, we pray right now for Pastor Patricia Hatch. Do for her what she cannot do for herself. God, not only we are decreeing that she's healed and made whole, but God, we decreeing the after effects of the three strokes that she have endured, that everything will go back to functioning the way you designed it to function. And Father, we pray right now for Deacon James Williams, Sister Linda. And Father, we believe in by faith that the work that you have started is not complete yet. Father, we pray that you give them complete health in their body, in their spiritual being, both mentally, physically, emotional health, in the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you right now for the praise report that's coming out of Tennessee, that the doctors have given Sister Jessica Nixon a clean bill of health concerning her diabetes. The doctor said that she do not even have to be stuck anymore. And God, we thank you for it right now. We praise you for it right now, God, because we know that you are a healer, a deliverer. And God, we pray even now for Sister Lily Lewis. Touch her even now, God, from the crown of her head down to the sole of her feet. God, the problem that they are seeking for when they do the surgery, God, I decree right now in the name of Jesus that they will not find what they're looking for. God, we decree that she's healed and made whole in Jesus' name. God, we thank you for the praise report coming from Apostle Brown that he is making progress. And we thank you for it right now. We thank you, God, for Mr. Jesse Johnson, that the praise report we got about him, that he is progressing. And we thank you for it right now, God, in the name of Jesus. And God, we pray even now for William Lord Nixon Sr. Give him a miracle of healing. Save, heal, and deliver him. We plead the blood of Jesus. And God, we plead the blood of our sister Jackie Floyd. And God, we pray that you give her complete restoration of her health, both spiritually, physically, mentally, emotionally. In Jesus' name we pray. And God, we pray for all of our spiritual leaders. We pray for the apostles, prophets, pastors, teachers, evangelists, all of our bishops, God. All of those of the Pentecostal persuasion and the apostolic doctrine. And all of the saints of God throughout the world, God, we lift them up even now. And God, we pray right now for all of our brothers and sisters that's on here by live streaming, both spiritual and financial breakthrough, in the name of Jesus. And God, we believe right now by faith that is already done. And God, I decree that your healing power, your word, God, you say you send the word and the word heal them. I send the word to the east, the west, the north, and the south. And I pray that you heal, deliver, and set free right now. God, we pray for all of our politicians that you will transform their minds out of the kingdom of God into the kingdom of your dear son, Jesus. God, we pray against Russia, oppression and aggression. In the name of Jesus, we know that you're able to stop this attack in its tracks. And we speak it right now by faith. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise God. All right. Are y'all excited about Jesus? I say, are you excited about Jesus? Amen. Thank God for Sister Cardell coming on. My God, my God. I can be unbreakable. We believe. For we believe. For we. All right, saints of God, I need to do this. I need to do this. I need to acknowledge everybody. Everybody out there that sowed a seed unto the Kenyon Project. I need to acknowledge you. Amen. Amen. We thank God for Minister Armstrong. We thank God for Bo Marcel, LLC. That's a business Sister Letitia Bose and Willard Nixon Jr. started. And they sold into the Kenya Project from their business. We thank God for Minister Alan Brown. Sold several seeds into the Kenyon Project. We thank God for Brother Paul Davison, Sister Rose Davis, Brother Roger and Sister Dorothy Dunn. We thank God for Evangelist Miranda Gilmore, Deacon Gilmore. We thank God for Sister Audrey Grimes. And she sold, saint. We thank God for Evangelist Hodges. We thank God for Sister Aria Hood. Thank God for Mother Ella Keller. We thank God for Sister Laura Maiden and also her mother that's on your wills today. God bless you, Sister Maiden. We appreciate you. We thank God for the seed that Sister Shalitha Martin sold. This is a young lady that had got killed after she had sold a seed a month or so after that. She had got killed in a car wreck. And we always like to acknowledge her. We thank God for Sister Taisha McCaleb. Sister Augustine Moore, Sister Tressa Nixon. We thank God for Sister Pearlie Stewart, Sister Michelle Turner Kirkland, Minister Brenda and Deacon Oliver Wallace. And if I miss anybody, oh, Pastor Hatch. I don't see his name on here. But we thank God for Pastor Hatch also. But we have all of these names, and anybody's name that I miss, I want you to know that we're going to send your names to all of our brothers and sisters that we're affiliated with in Africa. Amen. Because we want everybody to know that we appreciate your labor of love. All right. It's time for us what? Get wild. Thank God for Redrick Jones. God bless you. We appreciate you. We're talking about spiritual gift, right? And the reason why we're dealing with this subject about spiritual gift, because the Bible tells us that everyone have at least one spiritual gift. And so what the purpose, I'm on here every weekday for, well, almost every weekday. Thank God for Sister Aria Michelle coming on. God bless you. And we're on here talking Pentecostal truth and apostolic doctrine, because the Bible say they continue steadfast in apostle doctrine, breaking bread and in prayer. So what are we all about? Our theme for this hour is that it's time for us to get wild. Why? Because the Bible say that wisdom is the principal thing. And so what we all about? This hour, every day, is about edifying. That is to provide both moral and intellectual instruction. It's also for education. That is to bring out or bring forth the potential that within you, that you be the leader that God is calling you to be in this last day. It's also to empower you, to make you more stronger and confident, especially in controlling your life and claiming your rights as a child of God. All right, don't forget, like, tag, and share, and let everybody know one of the last of your old school prophets on the air teaching and preaching the unadulterated word of God, not for the love of money, not for fame or for glory, but that God will be glorified, the saints will be edified, Satan will be terrified and horrified, backslider will be restored, the sinner will be saved and delivered and set free by the power of the Holy Ghost. My God, my God. Don't forget, like, tag, and share. It's time for us to get busy. In this particular lesson which we are dealing with, these are the scriptures for all the new people that came on here. These are the scriptures that we are studying from. And we did add some scriptures that I don't have on my slide. 1 Peter chapter 4, verses 9 and 10. Now, if I remember correctly, we started at verse number 7, I think, and we went even further. But the point is, I give y'all these scriptures because I don't want people to say, Bishop Nixon said, Pastor Nixon said, Elder Nixon said, whatever you want to call me. I don't want you to be saying what I said. I want you to study this word. The psalmist said, thy word, O Lord, have I hid in my heart, that I may not sin against thee. The reason why, amen, thank God for my son-in-law coming on. I saw his name up earlier. The reason why people are spiritually weak is because they don't get spiritual nourishment. Come on. The Bible says, newborn babes, you should desire the sincere milk of the word that you may grow thereby. Are you listening to me? You can't get nourished spiritually just by going to church once a month or twice a month. I would go further than that. Once a week is not enough. I want to ask you a question. Do you eat your physical nourishment once a week? Or do you feast on physical nourishment every day? So now, if you need physical nourishment every day, practically every day to survive, well, what about your spiritual man? What about your soulless man? What about the inner man? Are you feeding him every day? Are you listening to me? Now, the other scripture I gave you was Romans chapter 12, verses 9 through 13. That's Romans chapter 12, verses 9 through 13. Acts chapter 16, verses 14 and 15. That's Acts chapter 16, verses 14 and 15. Luke chapter 10, verse number 38. Luke chapter 10, verse 38. Hebrews chapter 13, verses 1 and 2. So what are we dealing with today? We're dealing with the gift of hospitality. We're not through with that yet. I'm planning on finishing this up tomorrow. Because I think it's so important that we are hospitable to people. We read the scripture, but I need to go back to Hebrews chapter 13. Thank God for Evangelist King coming on. God bless you. We'll be looking forward to you showing up today. Now, I need you to get this. And this is the reason why I'm going back to Hebrews chapter 13. The Bible says, let brotherly love continue. The Living Bible says, continue to love each other with true brotherly love. If you're a child of God, the Bible says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. So if you're a child of God, you have to be hospitable to other people, even the one that are mean-spirited. Even the people that have lied on you and talked about you. Why? Because the Bible say the mind that Christ had, we're supposed to have the same mind. You're supposed to forgive those that despitefully use you. You have to forgive, forget, and move on. Catch this now. He said, let brotherly love continue. Then in verse 2, he said, be not forgetful to entertain strangers. For thereby some have entertained angels unaware. The Living Bible says, don't forget to be kind to strangers. For some who have done this have entertained angels without realizing. Man, that's powerful. That is powerful. Now, catch this. I need y'all to get verse number 3. Get this in your mind. Get this in your spirit. Because we yet talking about hospitality. We yet talking about, especially when you go to the house of God. People already struggling. People already dealing with things. And that's the reason why the first face that a person see when they come to a ministry that they're not acquainted with should be somebody with the gift of hospitality, somebody that's smiling, somebody that's very entreated, somebody that's kind. Now, verse number 3, remember them that are in bonds as bound with them, and them which suffer adversity as being yourselves also in the body. So God say, when you see people that's in trouble, when you see people that's afflicted, adversity. Don't you open up your mouth and say they could do better or they know better? Think about all the things that you did before you got saved. A lot of things we did before we got saved, we knew better. I did not need the Holy Ghost to know that lying and stealing and cursing and fighting and drinking. Are you listening to me? Getting drunk, doing drugs. I didn't need the Holy Ghost to tell me that stuff was wrong. Adultery, fornication. I didn't need the Holy Ghost to tell me that was wrong. I already knew that was wrong. So don't ever put down on somebody because they're struggling. Don't ever put down on somebody because they may be in a low place. As a matter of fact, I preached a message not long ago that God broke me out of a dark place. A lot of people's in a dark place in their life, and they don't need you to compile the weight that's already upon them. The Bible say, bear ye one another's burden, and so fulfill the law of Christ. And so it tells us when you see somebody in bond, let me read this out the Living Bible. Verse number 3, Hebrews chapter 13. Don't forget about those in jail. Suffer with them as though you were there yourself. Share the sorrow of those being mistreated, for you know what they are going through. This is so powerful that God telling us we have to learn how to love each other in spite of the person's situation, in spite of what the person's dealing with, in spite of where the person is at in life right then. Come on. And so that's the reason why I say it's time for us to get wiser. Now, when we're talking about the gift of hospitality, now I need to rehearse, thank God for advantage, what all coming on. I need to rehearse this in your spirit one more time, because I feel like every saint ought to be hospitable. How can you have the love of God in you and you mean as a junkyard dog? Are you listening to me? Now, the gift of hospitality, that's the special ability God gives the son to provide an open home, warm welcome to those in need of food, lodging, and fellowship. It involves a readiness to invite strangers to your home or to the house of God for the sake of the gospel. It is the divine enablement to care for people by providing fellowship, food, and shelter. Doesn't that sound like a saint? It's one thing to go to church, and one thing to have your name on a roll. It's another thing to be filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost, with evidence of speaking in another tongue. Because when you fill with the Holy Ghost, the Bible said that Christ that's in you is the hope of glory. Are you listening to me? So now, if you're full of Christ, if you're full of the Holy Ghost, how can you be mean? You have to be filled with compassion. You have to be filled with love. And that's the reason why I tell people all the time, I don't know anybody that I hate. It's very few people that I dislike. But I don't know anybody that I hate. As a matter of fact, it's not that I dislike people or certain people, but some people, they know how to push your button. They know how to get on your nerves. So I'd rather not be in their company. But when I'm in their company, I'm yet hospitable. I'm yet smiling, and I'm yet there to help them. That's what being saved is all about. Now, people with the gift of hospitality, people with this gift provide an environment where people feel valued and cared for. They meet new people and help them to feel welcome. They create a safe and comfortable setting where relationships can develop. They seek ways to connect people together into a meaningful relationship. They set people at ease in unfamiliar surroundings. Now, doesn't that sound like what a saint of God ought to be doing? Are you listening to me? I say, doesn't that sound just like what a saint of God ought to be doing anyway? We should be nice to people. We should be kind to people. We should be loving to people. Are you with me? So now, let's go to Acts chapter 16. Let's go to Acts chapter 16. And right here in Acts chapter 16, God bless you, my sister. Right here in Acts chapter 16 and verse number 14, we're dealing with a woman here that, thank God, Sister Andrea Hood coming on. Bless you. We're dealing with a woman here that had the gift of hospitality. Look at this. Catch this. See, we try to pattern our lives after everybody except after people that are great examples to us as being a child of God. You know, people, they train their children to be athletes and pattern their life after athletes. In the natural, I don't have too much of a problem with that. But what about the spiritual part? There must be balance. If we're going to be successful, if we're going to have everything that God wants us to have in our life, there must be balance. So we had to balance the spiritual with the natural. Now look at this later. In the book of Acts chapter 14, chapter 16, verse number 14. The Bible says, a certain woman named Lydia, a seller of purple of the city of Thyatira, which worshiped God and heard us, whose heart the Lord opened, that she attended unto the things which were spoken of Paul. See, it's not just enough to hear the word. We need to learn how to receive the word. Come on, talk to me. The Living Bible said one of them was Lydia that would listen to Paul and them minister at the riverside. A saleswoman from Thyatira, a merchant of purple cloth, she was already a worshiper of God, and she listened to us. The Lord opened my heart, and she accepted all that Paul was saying. You know, you have some people coming to the house of God, and they can read the word right out of the Bible. They don't believe what they read. Now, let me back up to verse 15. I started on the wrong verse. No, I started on 14. I'm sorry. Pray for me. Verse number 15. And when she was baptized in her household, she besought us, saying, if you have judged me to be faithful to the Lord, come into my house and abide there. And she constrained us. Oh my God. This woman had just met Paul and Paul and Silas, I think it was. Yeah. This woman had just met him. But she invited them to come into her house. She opened a home to these apostles. Now, here's the thing. When I was talking about the gift of hospitality, and I was talking about making people feel valued, making people feel cared for, we thank God for Sister Chantel Davis. I'm doing great. I'm doing great. Yes, yes. All right. God bless you, sister. I was just reading that message. All right, look, I need y'all to get this because these are the qualities that exemplify a child of God. Now the Bible says in verse 15, and when she was baptized in her household, she besought or begged us, saying, if you have judged me to be faithful to the Lord, come into my house and abide there, and she constrained us. You're talking about the love of God. That is the love of God. And what this word constrain means to persuade by strong pressure or force. Now, the Living Bible says she was baptized along with all her household and asked us to be her guest. If you agree that I'm faithful to the Lord, she said, come and stay at my home. And she urged us until we did. She was operating with the gift of hospitality. Are you with me? Now, let me go a little bit further. Let's go to Luke chapter 10, verse number 38. Luke 10, 38. If you stay with me, there are about 32 different gifts that's in the Word of God. And before I finish this lesson, every one of you all ought to find your place in the kingdom. Come on. Because God don't want you to just be a church pew sitter. God wants you to be a trend center. Are you with me? Now, let me see where I want to start with this. I want to start in Luke chapter 10. Let me go to verse number verse number 30. Verse number 30 said, and Jesus answered, said, a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell among thieves, which stripped him of his raiment and wounded him and departed, leaving him half dead. Are you with me? And by chance there came down a certain priest that way. And when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. Now I want you to find yourself in this scenario. Are you going to be like the priest that passed by on the other side? You see a person wounded. You see him half dead. Verse number 32, the Bible says, and a Levite, and likewise a Levite. Can I put it this way? The priest's assistant. When he was at the place, came and looked on him and passed by on the other side. At least he looked at him. The priest did not even look at the man. The Levite passed by on the other side, but he looked at it. Now, it's a bad thing that, thank God for Sister Lily Hood coming on, God bless you. It's a bad thing that if we say we are a child of God and see somebody in need and have the resources and the ability to help them and close a blind eye. Now, verse number 33, but a certain Samaritan. Now, I want you to get the text here, the context here, because the Samaritans in the eyes of the Jews were considered as dogs. Now, here we go. We got two preachers passed by. And here come the sinner. Verse number 33, and a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was. And when he saw him, he had compassion on him. What's wrong with this picture? Priest passed by. Scripture doesn't even say he looked at him. The Levite or the priest's assistant passed by. At least he looked at him. But here come the sinner. Here come the one that everybody looked over. Here come the one that everybody thought was nothing. Here come the one that they was calling dogs. Are you with me? The Bible says, but a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion upon him. Verse number 34 says, and he went to him. Lord Jesus, you mean to tell me that the sinner had to go minister to the man? He had two preachers pass by and did not minister to him? The Bible says, verse number 34 says, verse number 34 says, and he went to him and bound up his wound, pouring in oil and wine, set him on his own beast, and brought him to an inn and took care of him. That's compassion. Are you with me? All right, my time is up, beloved. Don't you go anywhere. Evangelist King have made her arrival, thank the Lord, and she's going to be praying and seeking God for everybody that's on you by live streaming, everybody on the prayer request list. So let's get ready to take this trip to the glory.
Hello, everyone. How y'all doing out there today? Sorry I didn't make it yesterday. Ended up wasting something all over my clothes. Had to go home. But I do appreciate you all. Thank God for each and every one of you all. We're getting ready to pray and trust God, amen, that all is well with you guys. Amen. Thank you, Lord God. God, I come today repenting for everything in me, God, that's not like you. I ask even now, God, that you would destroy it at the root, the very core and cause of it. Create within me, God, a clean heart. Renew within me a right spirit, that my prayers will not only be heard, God, but they will be answered. I thank you for being a keeper of my mind, my body, and my soul, God. I thank you, God, for life, health, and strength. I thank you, God, for all the listeners out there. I ask you to continue to bless them, keep them, Lord God, meet every need in their lives. And those that are not saved, God, I ask you even now, God, that you would touch them, God. Give them a mind, Lord God, to want to come to the knowledge of the truth. I thank you, Lord God, for our leader. I ask you to continue to bless him, keep him, Lord God. Meet every need in their life. Our first lady, Lord God, we thank you for her strength, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for everything that you're doing in her life, for her complete healing of her body, her mind, and her soul, Lord God. I thank you right now, God, for Bishop Daniel, First Lady Daniel, Bishop Brooks, First Lady Brooks, their family in their congregation, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, for the LDC, the PAW. I thank you, Lord God, that we just won't be an organization. We just won't be a group. I'm praying and trusting you, Lord God, that souls will be saved and come out of this group, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, let us be able to go on the highways and byways and compel men and women to come. We thank you, Lord God, for giving us a spirit, Lord God, to go out, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. I pray today, Lord God, as we get ready for a revival, Lord God, I thank you, Lord God, for reviving our souls, first of all, God. I thank you right now, God, for the saints being revived, God. I thank you, Lord God, for the unbelievers, Lord God, coming in, even as we get restored, Lord God. We believe in you, Lord God, that it's going to flow into the community, and somebody will have a mind to come and say, what must I do to be saved? I thank you, Lord God, even for the one that's going to run the revival. God, I thank you for Prophet Bethel, Lord God. I ask you, Lord God, that you would strengthen him even as he prepares to come forth, Lord God. Meet every need in his life, Lord God. Touch him, Lord God, where he needs to be touched, that he will be able to give us a fresh word, Lord God, that will be able, Lord God, to carry us on. We thank you right now, Lord God, for the fivefold ministry. We ask you, Lord God, that you continue to bless them, keep them, Lord God, meet every need in their life, but most of all, give us a word, Lord God, for these times such as this, Lord God. I thank you right now. I pray, Lord God, that you would give Sister Lenny Lewis a full recovery, whatever she has to do, God, whatever surgery she has to go through, God. I'm trusting you. I'm believing you. I'm standing on your word. By your stripes, she's already healed and made whole. We thank you, Lord God, for the recovery of Sister Wallace, Sister Armstrong, all those that have been dealing with illnesses in their body. We thank you right now, Lord God, for a full recovery over their body, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, for all the mothers and the elderly in our church, Lord God. I ask you even now, Lord God, that you will meet every need in their lives, strengthen their minds, their bodies, their soul, Lord God. And not only in our church, in each and every church that's out there listening, we pray for the elderly, Lord God, that you would do for them what they're not able to do for themselves. Meet every need in their life. And for that, we're going to give you glory. We're going to give you praise, Lord God. And most of all, look on our people in Africa, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, right now for Pastor Silas, for Pastor Daniel, and all the other listeners out there in Africa, Lord God. Meet the needs in their life. Lord God, strengthen their minds, their body, their souls, Lord God. We know, God, that you are God of more than enough, Lord God. And we thank you right now, Lord God. And that's our word for today. We shall have more than enough. In Jesus' name I pray today. Amen and amen.
All right, glory to God. Thank God for Ben's King. Thank God for the prayer. And the question of the hour is, do you believe God for it?
What? Say what? We are victorious?
Oh, yes. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. My time is up, beloved, and I appreciate you. Thank God for your patience. Tomorrow, 12 o'clock. Be it. I'm looking forward. to join the conclusion of this word, village and hospitality. In the middle of a battlefield, Saint. Oh my man. Never stop, never leave. Oh, every time. Point your hands at yourself and say, I am victorious. I am victorious. Now point at the screen. Say, you are victorious. And you are victorious. Now lift both hands and say, we are victorious. As always, saints, we love you. And we love you to life. In Jesus' name.